guys, so today we're going to be doing CHING number 84. If you hear any kind of racket in the background, my dog is playing downstairs having the time of her life. Okay, so we are going to start in with where we left off. So the first thing that I have, this person actually purchased three of these. These were those Kraft cheese singles plastic container boxes. I told you guys, and if you've been watching all my CHINGs, I sold every single one that I had. This person bought three of them for a total of $65.97. You know, yard sale season has started, and I kind of figured, you know, I might find more of these while I'm out yard sailing this year. I even said, like, you know, people might even throw them in, like, their free box, not realizing, you know, that there's any kind of value to these. And so far, since yard sales have started, I found three more of these Kraft cheese singles boxes. I think the most I paid for one was $1. The rest were 10 cents. So the next thing that we have is a sweater. This is by a company called Storybook Knits. They tend to make really kind of extravagant, just really pretty detailed pieces of clothing. And I had gotten a couple pieces by this brand at an auction. So this one sold for $39.99. So I do pick them up every so often when I see them. The more kind of outrageous they are, the better. I once sold one that had monkeys and bananas for buttons. So just, you know, very loud and unique pieces. This one was actually a little more toned down, but still really, you know, a lot of detail put into it kind of thing. So the next item we have is a Clinique makeup bag, and this had a few Clinique, what they call GWP items. Those are gift with purchase. So when you go to like a perfume counter and you buy a bottle of Clinique or some sort of Clinique skincare, they sometimes give you like a free with a purchase gift of just sample sized products and that type of thing. So when I find these out at yard sales and stuff like that, I tend to pick them up because there are instances where I have found lipsticks, and this is with Clinique and Estee Lauder. I found lipsticks in these bags that, you know, the shade is no longer made. They were discontinued and just the lipsticks themselves were selling really well. So this here was just, you know, as I stated, a makeup bag with a couple of smaller Clinique items in. So that sold for $16.99. The next item we have is a Coach makeup bag. This could also have been used as a wristlet or clutch. I did get this at a yard sale. I'd say I pay maybe $5 for it, and it sold for $28.99. I actually sold this already once before, so it's twice now that I found that while out in the wild and purchased it to resell. Next item, it did go to a subscriber named Margaret. This was a pink glass. It was three bunnies, kind of like the hens on the nest, but they were rabbits on like a basket. It was glass, like a candy dish. That sold for $29.99. I'm pretty sure that did come from an auction. Next item came from a yard sale. This was an Amari ginger jar vase. I'm pretty sure this would have once had a top to it. At the time, I didn't know that, like, when I purchased it. I just thought it was a really pretty piece. So yeah, I'm pretty sure that would have originally had a kind of like lid to it. But that still did sell for $39.99. Next item we have is a men's cologne. I had gotten a bunch of these perfumes and colognes at a yard sale by a company named Jafra. I paid $1 a piece for them. Some of them sold. I don't know how many more I have left, but this one was called Dopipo Uomo, and that sold for $45.99. Just yesterday, I sold a bunch of perfume, so that was really awesome. Next we have this is a vintage Polly Pocket doll. So this isn't a play set. This was just one of the teeny little dolls that go in one of the Polly Pocket play sets. Those are like the first things that gets lost in those Polly Pocket play sets. So people, you know, do look for just the Polly Pocket people. I had gotten a random baggie of some Polly Pocket people at a yard sale for a quarter, and this was in there. And she sold for $8.99 just by herself. Next item we have is a Madame Alexander piece of clothing. This was like a terry cloth beach cover up for a Madame Alexander doll that sold for $39.99. At one point, I had won a bunch of doll clothes at an auction, and guys, I still need to get through the tote that I won. I'm trying to figure out, you know, like I'm looking for stuff that might have tags in it and stuff like that to see if there's anything that's worth my while to list separately, and then I'm probably going to lot stuff up. Next item we have is a Tokidoki plush. This was called Donatella. Really cute. I got this at Goodwill. I probably paid $1.99 for it, and that sold for $12.99. Next item we have is a pair of Men's Aerotech Designs bike shorts. These were brand new with tags. I got these at a yard sale. I'm pretty sure I paid maybe $3 or $4 for them, and those sold for $39.99. Next item we have is a Nintendo DS Pokemon game. This was called the Pokemon Black. That sold for $99.99. That did come from an auction. And if you guys remember my last CHING video, I had told you I had sold this game and the person never paid for it. And I forget now what it sold for originally, but it was nowhere near the $99. So I relisted it and as a buy it now at that point, and just relisted it as a buy it now for $99.99, and it sold. So, you know, I'm kind of thankful the person didn't pay, because I ended up making more money in the long run. Next item we have is a set of glass, kind of Victorian looking vanity jar set. So just a really cute set to put on your vanity. At one point I had won quite a few pieces of just like these vanity sets at an auction. I wasn't quite sure how well that they would sell. They definitely aren't fast movers by any means, but this set did sell for $29.99. Let's see, next we have a latex Halloween mask. This sold for $29.99 as well. I do sometimes pick up Halloween masks, the latex ones, the older ones. This one here was marked Sri Lanka, and I had sold other latex Halloween masks marked Sri Lanka in the past, so that's why I decided to pick this one up. I do have a couple still listed though. So again, not fast movers. You know, someone might just be waiting until Halloween to really be looking, you know, for Halloween masks. Next we have, this was really cool. This was a store display for Neat watches, N-E-E-T, watch straps, I should say. So it was a cardboard store display that had all these different Neat watch straps on. Eric won this at an auction. I'd say he paid maybe $3 for it, and that sold for $29.99. Next we have another Pokemon item. This also came from an auction. This was a Bulbasaur Nightlight. I know Eric had won a couple of these. I'm not sure if we have any more available or not. We may. And I'm pretty sure he paid either $3 or $4 for that, and it sold for $39.99. Let's see. Next we have a Tamiya military miniature set. Eric won this at an auction as well. I'm pretty sure he paid $1 or $2 for it, and that sold for $14.99. That was brand new. Next we have a, oh, this was really cute. This was a bunny rabbit Easter plush, and he was called Jelly Bean, and on his feet, like his little feet toe beans looked like jelly beans. It was so cute. I got that at a yard sale. I probably paid a quarter or 50 cents for it, and he sold for $12.99. Next item we have is an Estee Lauder lipstick in the shade Elizabeth Pink. So this goes back to what I was saying about checking lipstick shades if you find like Clinique and Estee Lauder items while you're out yard selling. Obviously brand new. I got this lipstick at an estate sale. I paid a dollar for it, and that sold for $29.99. Next, we have a Spud McKenzie Bud Light mug. This thing was huge, absolutely ginormous. I'd say it stood like about this high and so thick glass, so heavy. I'm pretty sure that came from a yard sale, so I probably paid like a quarter or 50 cents for it. It wasn't really worth much. It sold for $12.99. Next, we have a perfume by Tova. This was just a lavender-scented Tova perfume. This did come from an auction. I probably paid a dollar for it, and it sold for $19.99. Next item also came from an auction. This was a Kent of London military brush set. When I saw this at the auction, I just happened to look it up. I had never heard of Kent of London, but you guys know I like to pick up older hairbrushes and stuff like that because some of them can sell really well. So I was really blown away when I was seeing listings and solds for this brand, Kent of London. I probably paid $5 for those brushes, and they sold for $99.99. Next item we have is a Fenton Custard Glass Fairy Lamp. This came from an auction, and that sold for $39.99. I sold a set of two vintage Garbage Pail Kids school folders. These actually had Garbage Pail Kids stickers like plastered like all on the inside of them. I'd say I paid maybe 25 cents a piece for those at a yard sale, and they sold for $12.99. Next was a Rock Candy pink Xbox controller. This came, I believe, on the same flat that I had won a couple other like video games at an auction. This sold for $11.99, so not a whole lot, but it was pretty and pink. Next we have a top. This was by a company called Westport. That sold for $14.99, and I feel like it's been a while since I said it, but you know where that top came from. That came from the Facebook Marketplace garbage bag of clothes. Guys, like I don't know if I've ever mentioned it before, I probably did. I do have a storage unit. I mainly purchased it, after I lost my parents, I, you know, kept some of their stuff, but I live in a townhouse. I don't have a lot of room for things, and there were some things, like some larger things I wanted to keep, but until, you know, I have my forever home, don't really have a place for them right now. So there are some of my inventory that I haven't listed, my death pile, if you may, in my storage unit, and I have a box still of clothes from that Facebook Marketplace sale that's still in the storage unit that I have to get listed. So it's just one of those things where, you know, you're sourcing constantly and trying to get everything up. Oh my gosh, you guys know. You understand how hard it can be to keep up with everything that you're bringing in. Next item we have is a pair of vintage Oshkosh bibs. These were a size 3T, striped kind of conductor looking style bibs. Those sold for $44.99, and those came from a yard sale. So probably paid about a dollar or $2 for them. Next item we have is a pair of shoes by a company called Taryn Rose. These were brown suede kind of wedge shoes. I picked these up at a thrift store. I'd say I paid $2 or $3 for them, and those sold for $19.99. They sat for a very long time. Next item was for a lot of two Avon Glazewear lip glosses in the shade Rave. Those sold for $13.99, and I probably paid about a dollar for those. Next item was a vintage Valentine's Day card that sold for $10.50. I had one, like a tray full of vintage Valentine's Day cards at an auction, and in the grand scheme of things, I probably should just list them all together in a lot. But I've been trying to do them singly just in case, you know, there is a certain one someone really wants to add to, you know, their collection and that type of thing. So at some point, they will probably just go into a lot. That's probably, like I said, what I should have done to begin with. Sometimes I struggle with that, like not knowing whether or not I want to list something singly or list something as a lot and that type of thing. So you have to let me know if that's something you struggle with as well, or if you just say, screw it, I'm putting it all into a lot type of thing, so you don't have to do everything singly. Next item we have is a Dooney and Burke wristlet. This one has Scotty dogs all over. That sold for $25.99, and that did come from a yard sale. I think I paid maybe $3 or $4 for it. Next, I have this really teensy little small handheld Art Deco looking mirror. I got this at a yard sale. I'd say maybe I paid a dollar for it, and that sold for $19.99. I sold a liquid blue Grateful Dead bear for $19.99. I had gotten three of these, I believe, at a yard sale. I think I paid $2 a piece for them, and I have one more left that hasn't sold. Next, we got a vintage black leather Coach bucket bag. I'm pretty sure I picked this one up at Goodwill. I'd say I pay maybe $6.99 or $7.99 for it, and that sold for $89.99. Next was a pair of Naot clogs. I bought these at a church yard sale, I believe it was. I'm pretty sure I paid $2 for those, and they sold for $39.99. Next item came from an auction. This was a ceramic, two ceramic figures by Arnott, and they were like connected together, and their little stickers said Love in Bloom. Those sold for $39. I know they were on a flat that we won at the auction, and I can't remember what we paid for the flat, but obviously it wasn't a lot. Next item was for a Fila long-sleeved kind of workout type top. This was from a Fila bag rummage sale. So in the grand scheme of things, I paid probably a dollar or less for it, and that sold for $9.99. This next item was really cool. This was a vintage Crystal Pepsi store banner. Eric purchased this at an auction. I'd say he paid, I think, less than $20 for it, and that sold for $59.99. So that was just like a really cool find. Let's see, we have a vintage from 1970 Barbie mod outfit. This sold for $69.99. When I was talking about the tub full of doll clothes, I also have a bunch of vintage Barbie clothes as well. And I have a question about vintage Barbie clothes. If anyone is watching this who could answer it for me, because I don't know everything. With vintage Barbie clothing, obviously some of it is tagged, right? It'll have a tag in that says Barbie or Mattel or Ken and that kind of thing. When I encounter vintage Barbie clothes, a lot of the Barbie clothes don't have tags. Are they the ones that don't have tags, are they handmade? How do you tell the difference between if something is like a genuine Barbie outfit and what is handmade? Would all vintage Barbie outfits and clothing pieces have tags, or do some not have tags? You'll have to let me know down in the comments, because I'm a little conflicted with some of the rest of the Barbie clothes I have. Now, these items were tagged, and when I did a Google search of them, I came to see, you know, what all went with the outfit that was in, you know, the case. But there's a lot of clothing that doesn't have tags. Kind of a little bit off ramble there. Next item we have is a pair of, no, this was a torrid floral skirt. It wasn't a pair, it was a skirt. That sold for $29.99, and that did come from a thrift store. I don't have another skirt. I'm thinking of pants. I have pants on the brain right now. I apologize. Anyway, next item we have is a vintage pair of Zodiac cowboy boots. Those sold for $79.99. They came from an auction. I'd say I paid $10 or less for those. So yeah, those were really cool. And they still had like the Zodiac inserts in them and everything. So I really don't think that they had ever been worn. Next item we have is a 100 and Dalmatians enamel pin set that sold for $39.99. At one point, Eric and I had won a bunch of Disney pin sets at an auction. I think I still have a couple sets left, but not many. A lot of them did sell. This next item was really interesting as well. This was a vintage Janston diving rubber swim cap. So, you know, something that you would wear on your head when you're swimming to not, you know, get your hair wet type of thing. Won this at an auction. I'd say I paid $1 to $2 for it. And that sold for $24.99. So people still are buying them. I don't know if they're using them or just collecting them or whatnot. Next item we have is a Fenton milk glass swung style type of vase that sold for $49.99, and that did come from an auction. I feel like swung vases and my Empoli glass pieces have really been selling lately. So I don't know why there's such an uptick in like the popularity of swung vases and Empoli. But those sales of what I have been like popping off. So if you ever come across any of that stuff, now is the time to get it listed, because it seems to be selling like really well right now. I'm seriously thinking of going to some antique stores and looking around for some more of them, because I think I sold both of my Empolis, and I think I'm down to like maybe one or two swung vases. Next item we have is a vintage Barbie Afghan hound dog. So this is like Barbie's pet dog, basically. I got this at a flea market. I think I paid $0.25 or $0.50 for it, and that sold for $15.99. I sold a vintage from 1991 Avon hairbrush for $25.99. Next item was a vintage PlayStation 1 game called Spyro the Dragon. This came from a yard sale. I'm pretty sure it was $1, and that sold for $12.99. Then the next three items were fishing related. Eric had won some fishing stuff at the auction. First thing was an Orvis fly fishing reel that sold for $51. I don't have down, you know, what he paid for these, but if you guys watch all of my hauls and stuff, like, I tell you, like, what I pay for stuff then, because I know it then, because I write it down then, and I don't always remember when I go to do my cha-chings. Next item was a pen reels fishing reel. That one sold for $93, so that was really awesome. And then the last item for this cha-ching was a vintage pearl bamboo fly fishing rod that sold for $53. So all in all, this was a really good cha-ching. I didn't have any issues with anything within this CHING. There was one thing that I wanted to mention with something though within this CHING. I had someone message me asking to refund them $5 for shipping. So, okay, I think that is just a little bit rude. Like, okay, I don't come up with a shipping cost. I do calculated shipping costs based on, you know, the dimensions of the box that the item is going in and the weight of the item. So to ask someone to give you back $5, you don't know as a buyer how much exactly, you know, it's costing to ship. So to just ask blatantly for $5 back, like, that's cutting into the shipping cost of your item type of thing. So I was just kind of blown away when I saw that message. Now, I do, you know, combine shipping costs, and I will refund any, you know, shipping costs that's like over what I needed to ship the item. That's not a problem. But this person only purchased, you know, the one thing, and specifically asking for $5 of their money back. It was just kind of mind-boggling. I did not give them the $5 back because, quite frankly, I couldn't. You know what I mean? I needed the shipping costs to ship their item. So, you know, it's just wild sometimes the messages that you get from people and that kind of thing. But yeah, like I said, I have no problem refunding shipping costs, you know, when I'm combining stuff and things like that. But that message kind of was just like, whoa, what's going on? Like, you know what I mean? You have to let me know if you've ever encountered someone like that, like demanding shipping money back and that type of thing. But other than that, no other issues within this specific CHING. I feel like my sales have been doing so good. Knock on wood. Sales have been fantastic. I feel like currently on like my 90 day total, I am at an all-time record high. So that's really awesome. You know, I've been getting a lot of sales and I have a lot of good stuff to list. Like, you know, yard sale season has started. I'm still going to auctions. I'm getting lots of really great inventory. I'm starting to get better inventory, things that, you know, I may pay a little more for, but I'm making a larger profit on. You know, not a lot of the stuff like in my eBay store, but, you know, there are some things like when I'm looking through my listings, I really kind of want to pull some stuff down, like stuff that's just stagnant, not going anywhere, and it's not listed for much anyway type of thing. And, you know, I still like buying the smalls and stuff like that and things that, you know, I may pay a quarter for and sell it for $10 type of thing, because that all does add up in the end. But I also am much more willing now, you know, to spend more to make a little more. When I first started, you know, resell from stuff that I'm finding at yard sales, I used to snub my nose. If something, you know, said $20 on it, I'm like, that is way too much for something at a yard sale. So, like, since I've been going to auctions and seeing, you know, what things sell for and that type of thing, and having to pay more for items, I'm no longer kind of snubbing my nose at higher price tags at yard sales, especially if I know that there's still a nice chunk of profit there, you know, to resell the items. So, yeah, I'm definitely more willing now to spend more than what I used to be. So that's also helping with, you know, my sales and everything like that. I will say one thing else too before I go. there have been a lot of issues within the past couple of days trying to list stuff on eBay using the eBay app. I'm sure they're doing some sort of updates and stuff like that, but it's been days since there have just been issues trying to list using the app on the phone. So if you list on your computer, you probably aren't noticing those issues. I do like to list using my phone. I feel like it's a lot quicker than it is to use the computer. So for the past couple of days, I've been having to use the computer, and I feel like it goes so much more slower for me than to just use my phone. So I'm hoping eBay gets their ish together and fixes the problem, because I'm getting really frustrated. It makes you not want to list, like when you're just having issues like that. Like, there shouldn't be those type of issues. I understand they happen, but for days to go by and they're still an issue, like, get with the program, eBay, get your stuff fixed, because, you know, that's less stuff that people are getting listed onto your site and making you money. So, I haven't listed anything yet today, so I'm hoping it's fixed by now, but we'll see. but that is pretty much everything for this cha-ching. I hope you guys enjoyed it. You'll have to let me know what you thought down in the comments. Let me know how sales have been for you, and I will see you guys next time.